The nice adventure around Sri Lanka continues, and today we are going to do a safari in the Uluru Eco Park, hoping to be able meeting the elephants. The excitement is huge and we can't wait to see them. We are not that far from the beautiful Habarana Lake, where we have already spent a few hours on a nice boat doing some bird watching. If you missed that episode, I leave for you the link and the description below. In general, Asian elephants are smaller than the African ones and have the highest body point on the head. The tip of their trunk has one finger-like process. Their back is convex or level. Females are usually smaller than males and have short or no tusks. Sri Lankan elephants are the largest subspecies, reaching a shoulder height of between 2 and 3.5 meters, weight between 2,000 and 5,500 kilograms, and have 19 pairs of ribs. Their skin color is darker than of Indicus and of Sumatranus, with larger and more distinct patches of depigmentation on ears, face, trunk and belly. Only the 7% of males bear tusks. The herd size in Sri Lanka ranges from 12 to 20 individuals or more. It is led by the oldest female or matriarch. In Sri Lanka, herds have been reported to contain nursing units consisting of lactating females and their young, and juvenile care units containing females with juveniles. Elephants are classified as mega herbivores and consume up to 150 kilograms of plant matter per day. They feed on a wide variety of food plants. The primary threat to Sri Lankan elephants is the loss of forests. The large blocks of forest they require are increasingly fragmented by clearing for human settlements and expanding agriculture in Sri Lanka. As a result of forest clearing, human-elephant conflicts have also increased and led to the destruction of property and death of both human and elephants. The problem is compounded by the elephant's preference for crops, such as sugarcane, bananas and other fruits frequently grown in the region. In 1997, about 126 wild elephants were lost as a result of human-elephant conflict, a rate of about 2.4 elephants per week. Current recorded levels of mortality would indicate that about the 6% of the animals in the wild are dying annually. During the armed conflict in Sri Lanka, elephants were maimed or killed by landmines. Between 1990 and 1994, a total of 261 wild elephants died either as a result of gunshot injuries or were killed by poachers and landmines. Several elephants stepped on landmines and were crippled. Between 1999 and the end of 2006, every year nearly 100 wild elephants were killed. Elephants are killed to protect crops and houses. Other threats are poaching, deforestation, drought and starvation. During drought seasons, many elephants damage agricultural land for food. Nearly 80 elephants were killed in northwestern Sri Lanka, 50 in south and east, and another 30 in the other parts of the country, totaling 160 elephant deaths in 2006 alone. In the historical past, elephants were widely distributed from sea level to the highest mountain ranges. They occurred in the dry zone, in the lowland wet zone as well as in the cold damp mountain forests. During the colonial period from 1505 to 1948, the wet zone was converted to commercially used fields and became heavily settled. Until 1830, elephants were so plentiful that their destruction was encouraged by the government and rewards were paid for any that was killed. In the first half of the 19th century, forests in the mountain zone were cleared large scale for the planting of coffee and afterwards tea. The elephant population in the mountains was extirpated. During the British rule, many bull elephants were killed by trophy hunters. One of the army majors is credited with having shot over 1,500 elephants, and two others are reputed to have shot half that number each. Many other sportsmen have shot about 250-300 animals during this time. Between 1829 and 1855 alone, more than 6,000 elephants were captured and shot. By the turn of the 20th century, elephants were still distributed over much of the island. The area currently known as Ruhuna National Park was the resident sportsman's shooting reserve, an area reserved for the sporting pleasure of British residents and the country. In the early 20th century, mega reservoirs were constructed in the dry zone for irrigated agriculture. Ancient irrigation systems were rehabilitated and people resettled. These developments gathered momentum after the independence in 1948. As a result, elephant habitat in the dry zone was severely fragmented. The size of wild elephant populations in Sri Lanka was estimated at 12,000 to 14,000 in the early 19th century, 10,000 in the early 20th century, 7,000 to 8,000 in around 1920. Between 1,745 and 2,455 individuals in 1969, between 2,500 and 3,435 in 1987, 1,967 in June 1993 that were fragmented in 5 regions, between 3,150 and 4,400 in 2000, 3,150 in 2006, 2,900 to 3,000 in 2007, 5,879 in 2011, on the basis of counting elephants at water holes in the dry season. Sri Lankan elephant population is now largely restricted to the dry zone in the north, east and southeast of Sri Lanka. Elephants are present in Udawalawe National Park, Yala National Park, Lunugamvehera National Park, Pilpatu National Park and Mineria National Park, but also live outside protected areas. It is estimated that Sri Lanka has the highest density of elephants in Asia. The Sri Lankan elephant population has fallen almost 65% since the turn of the 19th century. Today, the Sri Lanka elephant is protected under the Sri Lankan law and killing one carries the death penalty. The elephant conservation strategy of the Department of Wildlife Conservation aims at conserving as many viable populations as possible in as wide a range of suitable habitats as is feasible. This means protecting elephants both within the system of protected areas and as many animals outside these areas that the land can support and landholders will accept, and not restricting elephants to the protected area network alone. In the Pinawala Elephant Orphanage in Kegal, injured elephants are treated and orphaned baby elephants cared for. Nearly 70 elephants live here. Captive breeding is also going on. The Udawalawe Elephant Transit Center in Udawalawe National Park is a rehabilitation center where orphaned elephants' calves are being kept until they can be released into the wild. Elephants were a common element in Sinhalese and Sri Lanka Tamils heraldry for over 2,000 years and remained so through British colonial rule. The coat of arms and the flag of Ceylon government from 1875 to 1948 included an elephant, and even today, many institutions use the Sri Lankan elephant in their coat of arms and insignia. An important cultural symbiosis has continued to exist between the elephant and humans for over 2,000 years. No religious procession was complete without its retinue of elephants, and many large Buddhist temples and Hindu temples in Sri Lanka had their own elephants. If you didn't see the video that I shot at the temple in Kandy, I suggest you to watch it right now, because you can better understand the strong bond that exists between these beautiful animals and religion. In the description below, you can find the link of this blog. Also, today's episode finished, but don't get worried, because we will meet again soon with a new stop of this thrilling travel. Are you ready to learn something about the cultural exchange? In the next video, you will take part to a Taiwanese tea ceremony. You will learn how to cook some Mexican food, and you will see that people with different cultures and backgrounds can coexist and even have fun all together. If you still didn't do that, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon and stay tuned. See you next Monday. Ciao!